My Lord, the Diocesan Bishop of the Diocese of Lagos, the Right Reverend Dr. Bishop Humphrey Olumakai, the Managing Director of SecureID, Mrs. Kofo Akikugwe, the representatives of the First Bank MD and the MD of the Bank of Industry, the management and staff of SecureID, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Let me thank the Managing Director and Founder of SecureID, Mrs. Kofu Akikugwe, Madam Kofu Akikugwe, or Kofu, for the very kind and gracious invitation to visit. And I now know why she is such a remarkably successful and celebrated entrepreneur. She simply doesn't give up. I should have been here last year, perhaps even earlier. But one scheduling difficulty or the other, one clash after another made that impossible. But she simply stuck to her guns, and so I'm here today. I also must take this opportunity to thank you for your priceless contribution to the work of the Federal Government's Industrial and Competitiveness Council, of which you are a distinguished member. And also thank the chairman of SecureID for all of your contributions to ease of doing business and to industrial competitiveness in Nigeria. I'm extremely excited to be here at SecureID, this place of history, innovation, creativity, disruptiveness. I believe we all know by now that this world-class facility is reputed to be the first certified Smartcard manufacturing plant in sub-Saharan Africa, the only Smartcard production and personalization plant in West Africa, and one of only six, I believe, in the continent, and also one of 80 in the world. The facility, we're told, serves 21 countries across Africa and is fully certified by major and global commercial card companies, Visa, Verve, and MasterCard. So SecureID has shown that this country can be at the cutting edge of development in technology and digital enterprises. The world in which the companies like SecureID operate provides comprehensive end-to-end payment, identity management, digital security solutions, etc., is one that thrives on innovation. And the company has, in these few years of her existence, provided notable innovative offerings to financial services sector, to telecommunications, to government, and we've seen so many examples of that, to education, to healthcare, and private enterprise. So equally remarkable is the fact that with this facility, the company can produce all payment cards, SIM cards, loyalty cards, and the various identity management cards, residency cards, even voter registration cards, driver's licenses, and national IDs that are required in Nigeria with capacity to spare. That is simply awesome, because we have here in this facility all that we need to produce all of the security cards that this country may require. Congratulations also for your successes in getting the certifications that will help to the such as the global system of mobile applications, which you've talked about, the GSMA, Visa International, MasterCard, Verve, Card Quality Management, the CQM, GH Link, and ISO for smart cards as well. Manufacturing and personalization of credit and debit cards, I think you've just proved, you know, again and again, that all of this is possible and is possible here. In particular, I think we must also congratulate SecureID for earning the GSMA certificate last year. I think this is particularly important. This is a world-class security requirement for SIM card manufacturing and personalization. Your rapid expansion is also worthy of commendation, especially as you've added a number of subsidiaries, one of which is what we've just seen, the digital arm of the business, which you've described as the disruptive arm of the business, SID, I believe, Digital. while the other is involved in transport payment infrastructure. I must say that, you know, there is here, you know, what you see of all capitalists everywhere that desire to, you know, cover the field completely and make sure that nobody else is able to do much. So she makes the cards, and she also is now about to make digital cards so that if that becomes bad business, this other one will take off. Well done. This has put the company in good stead to provide services ranging from identity management to tax collection, school management systems, health management systems, digital cards for banks, and of course, e-ticketing for all forms of transportation, including road, rail, and water. We're extremely proud of your achievements thus far, and I believe that Nigeria's future will be defined substantially by how well we do in the three areas that SecureID focuses on, notably security, identity, and manufacturing. Data is, as we all know, the future of the knowledge economy. Today, data is building up at lightning speed. Our personal data and even behavioral attributes are gathered as we access services on financial, social, and entertainment platforms. The knowledge economy itself is the future of domestic and global growth and prosperity. So the integrity and safety of corporate data is critical, and personal data also is critical, especially against cyber attacks and fraud. Identity itself is, of course, critical to planning, to the implementation of government programs, especially our social investment programs, and for effectively expanding financial inclusion. Digital identification is fundamental for effective participation in the digital economy. This explains why we as a government are working hard on ensuring that we create an effective digital identity system for all Nigerians with the current NIN registration exercise. And then manufacturing. Our government also, following the recommendation of the Presidential Economic Advisory Council, has determined that manufacturing will be our main focus in bringing about dynamic growth, jobs, and exports. This will mean our retooling our business environment for greater competitiveness, especially with the takeoff of the African Continental Free Trade Agreement. We are rethinking our tax regimes. We are trying to sort out external and internal trade issues, getting our regulatory authorities, SON, NAFDAC, and even customs to see their roles more as business facilitators than policemen or merely revenue generators. Our environment must be friendly for local businesses first, and foreign investments will follow enthusiastically. Aside from the work that we're doing with other infrastructure, such as railroads and power, we're committed to a plan of democratizing broadband connectivity. A program which we've reiterated in our economic sustainability plan is the broadband connectivity for all by 2023. The Federal Ministry of Communications and Digital Economy recently launched the National Broadband Plan, which is designed to deliver data download speeds across Nigeria of a minimum of 25 Mbps in urban areas and 10 Mbps in rural areas, with effective coverage available to at least 90% of the population at affordable prices by the target date of 2023. Broadband connectivity is as important as electricity in the digital age. Unlike electricity, we do not have to make the several mistakes we made before getting it right. So we can get it right now, and we're working hard to do so. So I'm pleased to have seen firsthand what you're doing at SecureID. Your commitment and creativity and resilience is a metaphor for what our country is set to achieve. The economic future of our nation is extremely bright. Yes, we have challenges today, security and all manner of other challenges. And they may look daunting, but let me assure you that these issues will be resolved, and that the march of this nation to its manifest destiny as Africa's leading economic power will not be aborted. We are more than able to overcome. Once again, I thank the innovative and highly resourceful management and staff of SecureID, and had occasion to meet so many, the bright young minds, male and female, here in this excellent place. as well as all your partners and collaborators in this outstanding enterprise, for the very inspiring experience. And I wish you Godspeed as you take on and beat the best in the world. God bless SecureID, and God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Thank you.